Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday, dear Ripster. Happy birthday to me. What's going on, guys, and welcome to another Reputized video. Happy Birthday to Me came out back in 1981 and was directed by J. Lee Thompson and stars Meissa Sue Anderson. And it tells the story of this spirited young woman who returns to a private school after years in a coma from a deadly accident. Meanwhile, her friends end up missing and dead by a serial killer who picks them off one by one. As you can tell from the premise, this is a slasher. And yay me. Alright guys, getting into the positives. This felt like a throwback to the original Friday 13th. Because this actually came out a year after that film came out. So I think a lot of the inspiration that Friday 13th had, like with all the other slashers like Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Halloween, this movie I think was inspired by Friday 13th. I honestly do think that the creators of Scream and I Know What You Did Last Summer took inspiration from this movie. Because there was a lot there. A lot. The kills was good. The gore was somewhat extreme for an 80s flick and it was rated R. I wouldn't even mean the director's cut that I watched. It looked gory enough. It felt like a blend of Scream and I Know What You Did Last Summer. Most of the storyline kind of felt more Screamish in a way. Like I said, there was a lot of nudges towards Friday 13th and Halloween. It was pretty good. It was like I was watching a Friday 13th movie even though I know it was something else. It was one of those mystery type movies that we never get anymore where you see this killer killing people and you don't know who that person is. Nicholas Latey's cinematography work and lighting was done really well. Though it was somewhat dark in some of the scenes, but most of it involved the killer. I couldn't really tell what was going on, and I had the lights off, and I was watching it on Blu-ray. I still couldn't really tell everything that was going on, but I could see motions, and I got the gist of what was going on, which was never good. So I can't put that in a negative gist yet. I thought he did a really good job, so I'll just leave it at that. And like I said before, it made up with gore. Bo Harwood and Lance Rubin's score was just done excellently. Put a certain blend of what this movie score was like. And of course you have the happy birthday theme, which he made it like in a creepier version, of course, for a film of this magnitude. And you always have to have that score that pertains to the movie itself, that iconic whatever you're seeing in a movie-wise score. Like the Terminator had its own score. Halloween had its own. Friday 13th had that. Well, this one had its own. I thought he did a pretty good job piecing it together. And it felt really dark and eerie. The characters was done very well. The main girl played by Meissa Sue Anderson did a fantastic job. Although she did overreact a little bit in some scenes. But I'll get to that later in the negatives. She did a really good job. You really feel the trauma that she went through. Thompson's direction was pretty good. The writing was done excellently. By the third act, I was trying to figure out what the hell is going on. But by the end of it, when that twist came, ooh, I wasn't expecting that. I can't tell you guys what it is because even though this is an old movie, I try not to put spoilers in my videos. So I'll just tell you that it was really surprising. It was one of those Scream type moments. Which is why I'm putting it under the category of how Scream was like. And it was just fantastic. I was very satisfied, guys. Alright, the negatives. Some of the actors I felt kind of overreacted. Like, when you try too hard doing a horror movie, like a screaming scene or something, you kind of look silly. And it kind of takes you away from it. Now, no offense to the actors and actresses. I'm sure they did the best they could. And no offense to the actors and actresses of the 80s, but this isn't the only movie that they've done that in. It's just like with the overacting, they try so hard, it kind of comes off silly and you kind of are like, okay. But other than that, it was done okay. But the overacting I could have done without. It's like they tried a little too hard. And this may not be a big deal, but when I was watching it, one of the subplots was the main girl gets into a car accident with her mom, and it was showing the car take a dive into the water, but they did that like 4, 5, 6 times. And I'm thinking to myself, okay, we get it. They crashed. They went into the water. Move on. 2 shots would have done it. 2 or 3 shots would have done it. But this movie felt like a true horror masterpiece with its own. I felt like it was a really good slasher movie. I put that in right in with Halloween and Friday the 13th, mostly. My final thoughts on this, I recommend it to any horror freak out there like me. If you like Friday the 13th, Halloween, and Nightmare on Elm Street, or any of the classic slasher era, you are definitely going to enjoy this movie. Like I said, this came out back in 1981. Actually, the same year I think Friday Part 2 came out. So you will definitely enjoy this movie, and I recommend it for you. If you're a horror fan, and you liked Freddy and Jason and Michael. Happy Birthday to Me gets a B+. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I really do appreciate it. Like, subscribe, and get reputized. Make sure to subscribe to the Reactor Reactions Galore, which is down in the description below. And also make sure to like the Reactor and the Ripster on Facebook, which is also down below in the description. What did you think of Happy Birthday to Me? I'm sorry, that was stupid. What did you think of this movie? Did you like it as much as I did? Stay tuned for more reviews coming soon. Peace, the Rip out.